What's up, everyone? Welcome to another Mograph MoCast. I'm Dave.
And I'm Matt. And joining us for It Can't Mograph, this is all the best people in the world, including you! But mostly up on the wall over in this direction is our good friend, Mr. David Ariew, and the placeholder for EJ Hassenfratz once he gets off his phone call. Live from Camp Mograph!
And Mograph is a supplement to our site, Mograph.com, which is a motion graphics tutorial site with tutorials, plugins, podcasts, and other Mograph stuff. And on the show, we talk about everything ranging from motion graphics to Cinema 4D, After Effects, plugins, render engines, doing business, doing taxes, being a contractor, or working for the man. And none of that will be on the show today because we're just going to be talking about episode 200. If this is your first episode,
this is a good episode.
The last one,
this is a great
one.
Great one to start with. I'm super excited for you.
We're in the Camp Mograph set, if you're watching live, and yes.
This is exactly what Camp Mograph is going to look like.
Except not.
Except a little less fancy with the.
What we need to do is, while we're there, we take some pictures so that we can, like, you know, actually put us in there.
Build one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You know?
So this is episode 200. It's the 200 episode. So I'm going to start out with a pre-show warning. There might be some pretty bad outtakes in here later on. So just a heads up.
If you're triggered easily.
There. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. It's not that bad. And most of the bad stuff's toward the end of the show. But David, thanks for being on. EJ,
thanks for having me.
Possibly being on later.
Yeah.
And
I love you guys.
I love you guys.
Hold on,
I hope
guys. Let me go grab
this.
My craft beers.
Yeah. And Matt is frozen.
I'm frozen. I was about to say.
Matt is completely frozen. You're actually frozen on Skype, though. That's the problem.
Really?
So,
I can see myself moving.
Yeah, so if you could leave and come back in, that would be great. And
you want me to just completely leave?
Yeah. Oh, there we go. We got you there.
All right.
Yep. Okay.
What's up, Emiliano?
We've got clips, we've got call-ins, we've got video messages, and I've got scotch. I don't know about you guys, but that's where we're headed today.
Yeah, and Dave's taking 200 milligrams, 1 milligram of gummies
for each episode.
Not happening.
That's amazing.
We're also going to be doing a real review later on in the show.
And
we are going to be
ye old reels.
Yes. We're going to be reviewing the very first demo reels that we could all find of our own. So that's going to be a lot of fun. And what else do I have on the list here? We've got we're here to celebrate 16 days worth of podcasts. That's a lot. 16 days without stopping.
And honestly,
over 400 hours.
Thanks to all of y'all. Like, this is so great. The fact that we get to do this, you know, it's all because of y'all. We've met so many awesome people all because of this podcast, and the fact that y'all even listen is awesome. So,
and we got a lot of people to thank, actually. First of all, I want to thank Maxon for being so supportive of us all these years.
Yeah.
For one. Also, and everybody who works there, of course, Paul, Rick, Matthias, and all the Maxon peeps. David, you and EJ, all our guests, of course, that have been on over the years, and all the support from our family and from our friends and viewers like you.
It's also brought to you by the letter A and the number 200.
Yes, and the number 4.
Come on, 200.
Okay, that's better. That's better. Yeah. P is for podcast. So
yes.
We are going to take call-ins later on in the show.
Yes.
And this is another reason I hate Skype. I had a special dial-in number just for that. But for some reason, the audio input doesn't work just on that account. It doesn't make any sense to me, Skype. What is your problem, Skype?
So why didn't you just create a brand new account?
Because it would have the same problem most likely. Okay. That was a brand new account. So, I don't know. It's really weird. But, so you get to call my personal line. That'll be interesting.
This is going to be dangerous.
We will do that later in the show. Do not call during the show. Do not call when it's time to call. You only text us through Skype, and then we will call you. We will add you to the call. That's how it's going to work. That's later on in the show if we get to that, or we'll get to that at some point. But message us. Do not call unless summoned.
Right.
Also, real quick, I wanted to do the week wrap-up. Number one, we saw the new Deadmau5 show, which is interesting.
So good.
It's very good, and like the fact that it's all touch designer is really cool. We still got to see the first one.
What does touch designer do exactly? Like, how is it different from the other one? Resolume?
It's actually, like, from what I hear, it was started by, like, one of the guys who split off, who started Houdini. Like, basically, two of them were together, and then one wanted to go, like, VFX and stuff, and the other one wanted to go real-time, so they kind of split off, but it's very similar. Lots of nodes and stuff like that, you know. But what's cool about it is, like, the whole thing is real-time, so he has his touch designer hooked up to, what's the program? The audio program?
To Ableton,
right. Yeah, and then within Ableton, it's also connected to like this giant touchpad that he has that he's able to adjust the lights and the visuals live while he's adjusting audio as well. It's like, very cool.
Is he his own VJ then, basically?
Basically, that's crazy. He's got things laid out for the most part, but every show is different because he's, you know, changing and adjusting things live. Yeah,
that's really cool.
It's very cool.
And also he's got a deal in there where it's essentially front projecting everything onto the cube. So if the cube moves, all the video stays like in the same place.
It's super really cool. Yeah. It's a really, really good show. So
yeah.
That's awesome.
Makes me want to learn touch designer, that's for sure.
Yeah. And it's neat because like he said the whole show, like if you take out all like the rendered visuals and stuff like that, just the stuff that is in Touch Designer that was completely created in Touch Designer, it would fit on a floppy disk.
Whoa.
Yeah. And it's neat because it loads everything into the VRAM, like the entire show.
The
whole show loads into VRAM, and then that's why it's able to play real time. It's crazy. Super cool.
Yeah.
The Zed show is pretty time code locked. It was super fun to see.
Yeah.
Rad. The thing I did want to go over as far as just like actual week wrap up stuff though is the 3D Design Plus Motion tour.
Yes.
We're going to go to Chicago tomorrow and we are going to be doing a live show tomorrow night at 10 p.m. Central. That's not going to be released until the following Monday. So there are some dates on the tour that I'd like to mention.
But it will it will be live though, right? Like video?
What?
So if they're watching on YouTube?
Yeah. Okay. Tomorrow you can watch it live.
Yeah.
Yes.
But the audio
it won't be posted
to
audio until... Right. So I wanted to hit these dates so we knew what cities are coming up and we could tell everybody what's coming up. On the 3D Design Plus Motion Tour, you've got Seattle, which is tomorrow, the 17th. You've got Vancouver, September 22nd. San Francisco is September 24th. Antwerp, Belgium, September 27th. And London, October 1st, which I'm guessing Phil will not make that because he'll be on a flight coming over here.
Yeah.
So
can't wait to see Phil. It's been way too long.
I know.
Yeah.
Missed that guy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Last week or the week before, there was the Austin show that we were at, and that is posted online now. Also, this Thursday, if you want to see the Toronto video, that'll be premiering on our channel, and I'm working on the Chicago panel right now to post as well. I think that wraps it up for that. We do have a lot of outtakes today, including one. We could go ahead and show this one now if you want.
Oh, is this from the
Austin panel?
Okay, cool.
Yeah, since EJ's not here, we can
at
go
least
ahead
get
and
a taste of
one.
The EJ.
Yeah, here we go.
We have Matt Milstead and Dave Koss from Mograph.com and Nexus Motion.
I love you guys.
I love you.
So we got a whole bunch of those types of things coming up in the show. And we already said all our thanks, which is good. So I'm going to go ahead and maybe EJ will show up while we're doing these outtakes here. But I have a short version of some outtakes. And the one thing that I have noticed about our show is we make a lot of random noises and sounds. So let's check out this short outtakes segment.
Welcome. This is Mograph Live.
This is how I'll be talking normally when we record. It'll sound a little something like this. Oh, yeah, shit. When that happens, bah! Oh, I'm excited.
How's Madam Secretary going to get out of this one? Wow.
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 Damn it, Bobby.
But the emojis animate. That's what the poor people do, right?
I don't get that.
I don't get that.
I don't know what we're talking about. I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I don't know. That those weren't too crude. There might be some other crude ones later. I mean, you know, we're not that crude. We space it out over 4 years, but when you put it all together,
right.
So I wanted to quickly talk about the history of the Mograph podcast, because Matt and I met working at a crappy commercial company making jingle commercials.
Yep.
And that was a lot of fun. And the two of us basically said, you know what? The day we met, we're like, we want to do tutorials on the internet.
It was when I really interviewed fun. For the job. It was kind of when I interviewed for the job.
Yeah.
You know?
You weren't even really hired yet. No. So the two of us were trying to come up with a name for the show.
Yep.
And we were like, hey, we're bros doing Mograph.
And then you pounded fists. You're like, whoa.
And then we pounded fists, right.
And our chests,
however,
too.
And your chests. You just did a bunch of manly grunts and things. And,
yeah.
We did Tim Allen grunts for like 20 minutes straight.
What? But that's the thing. At the time, it was just both of us. And we were like, yeah, I don't have any of those outtakes. Yeah. But at the time, it was just the two of us, you know, and that was the whole thing. We're bros doing Mograph. But as time went along, we decided to do the show, which really Matt was pushing to do the podcast.
I was.
And I had done a podcast in the past, and I was like, but we started having guests and stuff like that. Then people started using that name, not knowing who we were, using the word Brograph in a derogatory manner, I guess. And so the thing is, then people thought that we were doing that on purpose to be mean, which we weren't. So we decided to rebrand, and we bought Mograph.com for a lot of money.
A lot of
money. From a web squatter. and we changed it, and we rebranded, and we did tutorials for a while. Hopefully we'll do tutorials again. But I did find some clips of the first live show that we did. We actually did a live show before we did a podcast.
Did I ever tell you about the live show? That the one person who showed up who was asking all the questions was actually my wife. Disguised.
The penguin dude?
No, someone else.
That's adorable.
Yeah.
Oh. No, I remember.
Did I just like break your heart?
Guy.
You're like, oh, I thought we had a fan.
Yeah, one person. We had like two. Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, they
Rick
were good
Bogus
questions,
in the chat.
So.
He says, question in the for the chat. He's like, can you remember approximately the first episode that you heard or saw or how you discovered Mograph?
Yeah, I'm curious how everyone discovered
I started from episode one and continued listening. Yeah. I'm your super fan.
Yeah, you are. We're your super fan now.
And that's the thing. That's the other thing. That's how we met you, is through the show.
That's
yeah,
true.
Because if it wasn't
you
for you,
Alexa.
If it wasn't for you, we would not be anywhere. This is all you.
That's not true at all. You guys built it up gradually on your own. And yeah.
Nah.
Well, if you want to see our first live stream, I'm going to bring it up. This is before the podcast. So this is just us.
Oh, I know
whatever,
what you're doing
And I think
here.
A lot of people
I know
are going to love
this. You're doing
clip.
Here.
So, yeah. So, let's check it out here.
I love projects that scare me. That like it, when our art director comes to us and asks for something that I had never done before, and I have to figure out how to do it.
That's always
that's
the best.
What kind of it scares me to death. But man, it gets me pumped.
Gosh,
and that's where the line came from.
So yeah, and then y'all then like bastardized it.
Then we did the started the podcast 4 years ago, and so I have a clip here of the first episode. So I'm going to play that here. I think it's pretty funny to listen to now. So let's check that out.
Oh yeah, all the.
I love that,
that terrible intro
music.
Man, it was so bad. It's like, I remember like the
it's
old
like
fist.
Classic.
Hold on. What's up, bros? Welcome to the very first Brograph podcast. I'm Dave.
And I am Matt.
And we have decided to do this, I don't know, what do you think, like every month or so? And
yeah, you know, once there's some big cinema 4D or 3D, you know, animation news.
I sound out of breath.
Figured there was a lot of stuff, you know, coming up this past month with V-Ray and Octane and SIGGRAPH and stuff. So, you know, this is a good time to do it. Better time than any.
Yeah, or whenever we feel like we have some stuff we want to talk about. We're going to talk about animation as well. I guess it just won't be just Cinema 4D, but maybe a little bit of After Effects too, or
yeah,
whatever has to do with that, I guess.
Yeah, Adobe just released the new Creative Cloud.
So that was a while ago. And
I have a bit more energy now.
Yeah.
Of course, I was. We were also doing the show at like 9 p.m. at night on a Sunday night. Versus now it's like Monday afternoon. We've got so much more energy.
I would post it too.
It's my morning now since I moved to California, so I have very less energy.
Right. Yeah, you used to get on like at 2 o'clock in the afternoon with us or something.
Yeah.
Oh, and yeah, that's right. You would do it if you would be on, it was like so late, dude.
That's
we'd finish the show, it'd be like 3 o'clock in the morning your time when you first started.
I'm a night owl though. Like mornings are not my thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
V-Ray. Yeah, we I know, right?
Octane
V-Ray. V-Ray. Yeah, that dates the podcast for sure.
Yeah.
V-Ray mattered.
Right. Yep. I don't know. Maybe we'll come back. I don't know. But then
He's trying.
You know, Dave, it's bugging me that the flag is like right behind your head.
It's true. Yeah. Like design freak out right now. Yeah.
Yeah. Mm,
I'll have to move it
just
next
re-render
time.
It.
Yeah, if you could just re-render the whole thing.
Put a strain on the system at all. Well, here's the thing, is I'd put it here, but this is my collar box.
Yeah, but like, it's better that when the collar box is off, you've got
it just goes on top of it.
All Sorry, right. we're well, over I'll here art directing you right now. Yeah. Is it getting you hot?
Yeah. Man, it gets me pumped.
Man, it gets me pumped.
All right.
I'm glad we at least got that out of the way. All right?
Actually, David, you were there. We did the Bro to the Future episode.
Bro to the Future.
Pretended it was 10 episodes in the future.
No, 10 years
ten
into the future.
Years in the future.
Yeah. And, I loved the cover art for that one with the photoshopping our faces into the Back to the Future.
Oh, yeah, that was me. That was all me.
Yeah.
It was beautiful.
And it was like really, really hard to edit because we just basically sat there like ad-libbing things and cracking up.
Here's the thing about Dave. Dave is always very prepared for no matter what we do, right? And this one, he had an entire outline done, you know, and I think David, even too, but like I would just like, I just winged it the whole time and would throw in terrible, awful, like oh, now
so
I'm completely
bad.
Changing the future here. Yeah. Keep on cracking up the whole time. Oh man.
But Dave like hid his jokes from us, and so we were surprised every time.
Oh yes.
Yeah.
Together.
Oh, he still does that. That's what he's doing right now.
Oh, you want to hear some examples?
That's what this whole show
I got
is.
Some
we
examples.
Sure do.
Yeah.
All right, let's see I got two examples of us trying to do that during the show. Here we go. Because the last thing we want on our hands is another render Hitler. So.
Yeah. It's cuz you've got these one-liners that you didn't tell us about.
Zing. I got another one here, too. We went to video about 5 years ago after we bought Grayscale Gorilla. I can't say that without laughing. Oh, man.
Reset. Back to one.
I didn't think it was going to be that funny, but...
Okay.
All right, here we go. Yeah. I got some great clips, man. So, so
where
then,
is EJ?
For some reason, I know.
This is going to be the whole show. This is going to be the gag for the whole show. EJ actually just never shows up.
Mm-hmm. Well, he had a 12:20 call as well, so now he's just straight on
that
next phone call.
He's probably walking the dog, and then he's got to go and run.
Mow the lawn.
And then he's got to mow the lawn, and then he's got to go drive to get coffee and come back. Right. So it just makes sense for EJ's life. You know?
If you could just stick that picture of Beeple, like, in you know, the one right here.
I'll just put a pretend EJ up.
Aww.
I'll just put a pretend photo of EJ in there. Okay, so let's move on a little bit. I got a lot of clips. It might be a long show. All right.
I missed that old cheesy music. It's going to be a short show. Those garage band tracks, you know.
Yeah, it's like a short show.
From that sound, what is it, Soundtrack Pro or whatever, those Apple loops.
Oh, Soundtrack Pro, whatever happened to that?
I feel like that's how you made that intro music. I recognize the
sound. I think it was.
Oh, yeah. Definitely Apple loops. Yeah. With me just adding a couple little things on my keyboard, for sure.
Because I used that back in, like, 2007 or something. Like, that exact same thing for some cheesy thing I did for the library, you know, like, one of my first video edits. So, yeah. Brings back memories.
Yeah, I took, like, five of those things and then added like a piano note at the end or something. I don't know.
Right.
Ding.
I don't even know. Like I don't know.
Oh my gosh.
Ash says,
yes,
one of the first episodes I listened to, I think Dave was talking about a trip to Mexico and had a mini panic about the water before remembering.
He had been drinking red Gatorade.
Oh, yes, I forgot about that. The red Gatorade. Okay, I do have that clip for later in the show.
Yeah, you do.
But I forgot about the red Gatorade part, so we'll talk about that at that point. Okay, one of the things that Matt and I do a lot on the show is we always do the Jimmy Stewart voice for some reason.
Right. Yeah.
So,
hey, it's your mom.
Yeah.
It's my mom.
And I used to... I wanted to tell you guys before we start the show, when we roll the clips... When we roll the clips, just don't say anything. You can laugh, but like, don't say anything over it because it's gonna make it super hard for me to edit, and I'm a lazy editor.
I'm just gonna scream the whole time over this next one.
All right, so I have like a minute clip here of what we do when we get into our Jimmy Stewart voice for some reason. Here we go.
Mary.
Oh no!
Oh dear!
You're a regular person,
Mary. Mary.
Mary. Mary. I want a big one. Hot dog.
Oh, yeah. Because every time he goes, oh, man, I forgot about that one. Yeah. Well, he's over there, and she's right there. This is a very interesting situation.
Maybe I can sell tickets.
All right.
You want the moon,
show.
Mary? I'll throw a lasso around it.
Lasso around that moon. I'll get you that, Mary.
Mary.
Poor George Bailey. It's like the saddest movie in the entire world. All he wants to do is travel, and he can't.
I know.
He's got to keep on dealing with other people's crap.
Because of his stupid kids.
Why did I just come out of the top? Why'd you have to get sick?
I don't have your money, Matt. It's in cryptocurrency.
It's in Bill's house and Fred's house.
And then we were hanging out with Phil when we started doing it.
If I shave this, it'll be like, oh, Matt, you look so skinny.
Oh,
but
Matt,
you still got a gut. What's with that?
You look so skinny.
Skinny fat.
You need some meat on your bones,
so
Mary.
Skinny, Mary.
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 Eat some potatoes, Mary. And then whenever we started doing the live shows... Oh, just wait till we get to, like, the Matt laughing clip. It's so great. So we started doing... See, he's losing it already.
Yep.
We started doing, like, the live stuff, and so Matt started doing Snapchat filters on his face the whole time. Which,
this.
Of course, most of the audience listens to audio, so, like, they don't even know what's going on. He's losing it. Oh, man. So David starts trying to, like, explain to the audience what is going on. So here's that clip.
For those listening, Matt has downloaded some Snapchat-esque thing for Skype, and I don't even know how many filters there are. Yeah he's like, and using catchphrases like, does not compute, and then his face turns into a giant computer.
I'm a computer. Stop all the downloading.
And then there's Beeple.
That guy.
Beeple.
I'm going to need a nap actually, after this.
We found out that he was actually, well, he downloaded our plugin for one. Then we found out he bought
our plugin, and we were like, oh, Mike Winkleman. I know that name. And it's like, yeah, sure enough. Holy crap, he listens.
Yeah, so I got four Beeple clips here to play. Number one is the origin of Beeple's people, because it was the three of us. We were on the show, and we got on this topic, so I figured I will play that first. This clip's a little bit long, but it's fun to hear. The people at home will like it, I think, so let's check this one out.
Did you see Beeple's newest daily render today?
No.
News feed? It is so good.
All right, gonna go look at it.
Yeah, looking right now.
It's so good.
I like this ghost box one. This one's nice, though. I love the vine. I feel like this is... Maybe he's getting into Ivy Grower, because there's some nice... Ivy going on. I need to get into
this
Ivy
is the portion of the show where we critique Beeple. We're just going through the feed.
We've got Ravcock, we've got like social media.
New segment. We go through all seven of them every week. Oh my god, that's we're like gonna really do that idea. Now.
Yeah. It's like, I think he was pretty low on effort on this one.
Yes.
We do the Beeple review. We can become those guys really that like make it. Up really elaborate stories.
That's what I'm saying. We'll come up with a story. We'll talk about how it was technically made, but we're going to come up with a story for each one. Oh, dude.
Oh, new segment. That's really good.
It's pretty good. Yeah, I like it.
Okay. Okay.
Do you think
this is how our show becomes 3 hours long?
Yeah, that's true.
Right. If you don't want a 3 hour show, then you guys need to shut up.
I think we do need to do a couple of these though, because like I'm feeling this vibe right now.
I'm pretty sure it's Forrester, but then change the colors to orange and blue.
Yeah, actually,
I can't do this seriously.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, so now the pillars.
Oh my gosh.
Pillars,
no.
Is there any displacement?
Matt, you just need to leave now.
They're okay, before this. We go, you guys do have
I'm
to
gonna
go
ahead and
start
apologize to all of our listeners now. That was terrible.
Everybody's going
to
say that was
that
the
again.
Freaking best. Do that every week.
Yeah, so.
Yeah, I love the bored look on Matt's face. Like, this is hilarious. Like,
I would want to stay in the flower. Like, this flower oasis.
Like, he has a jacket. He's holding a piece of paper like it's a map or a tour guide.
I think you guys are doing this just to piss me off.
Matt, this is very serious.
All right.
All right. We'll stay tuned next week for Beeple's People, where we will...
No! Beeple's People?
I don't know.
Don't call it that. No!
And now it's time for the Beeple's People segment. I need to mute the mic.
I'm leaving all of this in.
Beeple, Beeple. Oh my gosh. I hate you so much right now.
Pro video podcast.
I swear next week if you bring up Beeple's people, I am turning it off. And
with
I am
EJ?
Oh,
man.
Yeah, no, we're going to be at SIGGRAPH. We have to do
and,
this.
And what if we actually got Beeple?
You know what? No. If
would
we
there
got
be Beeple Inception?
Beeple's people.
How does he explain his own stuff?
No. Beeple's people is not becoming a thing.
Oh, God.
It's not. No. I don't know what it's...
Stop trying to make Beeple's people happen. It's not going to happen. And we know the episode name now too. I swear we didn't smoke weed before the show. We totally sound like it. Oh, this is ridiculous.
Yeah, I can't even talk right now. It's so stupid.
Oh, stop trying to make people's people happen. That's so funny. All right, let's get out of here.
Yes.
Oh, man, I just came up with a new shirt.
Did you?
Beeple's
people. better get on that. We're gonna wear. Or you got to do it now so we can wear it to Seagraph.
Oh man!
And you know what? We're gonna sell them, and what? And it's gonna go to his favorite charity.
All right. All right. I'm fine with that. Okay. Oh, that's a new charity for people. It's people's people.
Oh my gosh.
I like it.
So it goes to his own charity? That's not fair.
Oh my god. Oh,
man. Every second of this in.
Can we please sign off?
All right.
Man, right,
so nothing has you changed. Know what, Matt still hates it.
I do. And it's not a gag. Like, it's not a gag. I literally do hate the show.
I know you hate it.
Yeah, I know.
That's why you go to the bathroom every time.
Yep.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh my gosh.
All right, so
you're just like then, making a
see,
poop
like
emoji
well,
every time.
Here's the thing. Did you grab the did you grab the one at Siggraph where they started singing Beeple's People for the first time? Did you grab that?
No.
Because they came up with that at Siggraph or like the day before or something like that, you know, that would have been great. Anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know where that was that in the, in
that was in the show. Yeah. That was in the episode.
Oh really?
Yeah. If you want, I can go and look for it real quick. Then
I'd have to format it and all those things. Sorry. I can put it in the show notes if you send it to me. All right. So then we actually had people on the show a couple of times and Matt, you played a game.
Yes. This was a good game.
Mike.
This is a good game.
This is a good game.
Yeah.
So I have a clip of that right here.
I think
you
were
gonna
there's
no chance in hell that I get one of these wrong.
All right.
Prove me wrong, kids. Right. Prove me wrong.
Okay.
At any point do you ever
actually,
see a render
fuck. I had to take a double take on that. That's definitely not mine, but I'm going to be honest. I didn't have to look a little closer.
I don't even know the answers. Matt's going to have to tell me.
Not mine.
That's not yours? That is correct.
All
ding.
Right. You need the bell. I
got the bell. That was a little harder than I thought it was going to be.
All right. Next one.
That's mine.
That's yours? That is right. Good job. All okay. Right. Next one.
This is
not mine.
So, wait, what'd you say?
Not mine.
Wrong! That is yours!
Shut the fuck up! No, it's not.
It is yours. That is yours.
What game?
Hold on.
That's throwback. Hold on.
Yeah.
Fine. Yep. I told you if you went way back, you might get me. Okay, fine. Fuck. That's mine.
This one right here?
Yeah.
That is correct. Okay. That is yours. Alright, hold on. I need to go to the... Alright.
No.
Correct. That is someone else's. All right.
This is hard to do. I should have had a better Beeple viewer of choice.
Help.
Correct. That is not you.
I think we're nearing the end.
Help.
That is not you. Correct. All right.
Yep.
Yeah, that is you. Correct.
Yep.
Yeah.
You remember this one. That was the one he did called Bros. That was after the first time we talked to him, the four of us.
Yeah, we've all got a print.
Yeah, that was good. Let's see. You crying enough there, Matt?
Man, it's funny.
Take your nap.
I've cried more during this episode than I did at my grandfather's funeral this weekend.
Oh,
you're a terrible person.
Jeez.
But here, I'm not trying to hold back the tears. There I was.
Ah, yes. All right. Beeple at Seagraph this year. So this is relatively new. But this is a two-minute segment that I kind of chopped in.
This one's with Casey, right?
This is when him and Casey took the mics with us. And actually, David, you and Shmoopy are in there, too. So here, I'll play this one. Do.
Hey. What the fuck is this? Is this the fucking mic?
Yes. Hey.
What's up, buddy?
What's up, man? How you doing?
Good.
No,
doing good.
Casey? Guys, no way, dude. No way, dude.
Wait.
We're going to talk about both. Yeah.
What do you want me to say?
Buzz Lightmail.
We're going to ask you where it came from.
I have
it was
no
all bait
idea.
For Joe Rogan. He's trying to get back on that Joe Rogan train.
When I was making that, I really thought to myself,
self?
I really thought to myself, this is exactly what I should be doing. And this is like, this realization that it's like, wait, this is what I'm supposed to be doing? Like making a fucking nipply Buzz Lightyear.
A quad nipple. I wish I could actually visit that, because that looks, in, like, I mean, like, you've been
wait, you
deals.
Live
you've,
here. You've, what the fuck are you talking doing, about? Visit
I
it.
Can't go there. That
the fuck bad. You I mean, can't. Just fucking come out. Don't be a fucking little bitch.
Because Mike has this thing where if you do 100 dailies in a row,
wait,
you,
whoa, yeah, whoa, you, whoa, whoa,
he'll
bro.
Send you $100.
Yeah, yes.
Yeah. If you do 100 dailies in a row, no, Mike Winkleman will send you $100. $100 from Mike Winkleman if you do 100 dailies consecutively. We are in the actual render wars. We have memes about it all over the place, but we're actually in it now.
Oh, sorry, I'm excited about render engines at SIGGRAPH, Mike. Oh, I'm sorry, are there something that you need to put nipples on that you're too... Is there something you need nipples for right now that I'm bothering you with at 12:15 in Los Angeles? No, yeah, dongle life is a total thing.
Dongle
I'm
life.
Just saying.
12:15, what the fuck are you talking about?
See, that's... I called it. I knew
off.
Inside his
that's
head.
My, that's yeah. Rapid the fuck okay.
And then he sent this clip. It's really fast and it's kind of soft, so you're gonna have to like hold on for it. Okay, check it out.
It's pretty good, I guess. It's pretty good, I guess.
Did you hear it?
Yep.
Should I
he
do
sent
again?
That?
Should I? Do...
He said that.
What?
He said that.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
That's
I'll play
funny.
It again. Listen.
That's awesome.
It's pretty good, I guess.
Pretty good, I guess. Okay. Oh man. All right. So still no sign of EJ.
God damn it.
Where's EJ? Where's EJ.com?
Of course where he bails on the... Where's EJ.com? Drinking coffee, having beers.
Man.
I'm gonna grab
tasting
that...
that mountain air.
I'm gonna grab that domain gonna... name and just, like, go ahead and, like, put something up, like, by the end of the show.
All right, here's the... And so it's just a blank website?
We should just Photoshop some, like, happy anime eyes on EJ and, like, throw that photo up there.
Do
yeah,
character
some
animator.
Googly eyes.
So that
yeah.
We can
oh,
do
man.
EJ's voice.
Hello, I'm EJ.
Or do like a,
I'm EJ,
a Canadian fast. South Park, you
yeah.
Know, flappy head.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, guy.
Hey, guy.
I'm not your I'm buddy, EJ. Guy.
I'm not your friend, buddy.
I'm not your
I'm not
buddy,
your buddy,
guy.
I'm not your
right.
Friend, guy.
So, this segment, Matt has not seen a lot of this, and I really think he's going to
oh boy.
Super enjoy this segment coming up. No, this is actually super cool. It is, however, it is 7 minutes and 30 seconds long.
Ooh.
You're damn. Really going to enjoy this, though. So, in the meantime, I'm gonna crack open a little bit of this 18-year-old scotch and have just a little bit of it in celebration of...
Wish you would.
200 episodes. All right, here
gonna...
we go.
I'm gonna
all
eat
right.
A crunchy bar.
Okay,
nice.
You guys, take a little break, but don't miss this. It's you're gonna like this. It's really fun.
It only took 189 episodes for me to properly join you on the podcast. Congratulations on 200, and here's to 200 more.
Bam!
Yeah.
Aww.
What's up, guys? Wow! Congratulations on 200 short episodes. Oh wait, hold on. At 2.5 to 3.5 hours average. Wait. Not short episodes. That's a lot of hours. Well, congrats to 200 very long episodes, and here's to 200 plus many more.
You guys look fantastic considering how many episodes you guys have done already. In celebration of this, I want to share with you a little joke that my 7-year-old son told me the other day. He said, hey, Dad, why did the chicken cross the road? I don't know. So he can walk across the street and talk to the moron. Okay. Hey, Dad. What? Knock, knock. Huh? Who's there? Chicken.
Ah!
Either way, congratulations.
That was pretty good.
Hey, Matt and Dave. Congratulations on 200 episodes. I mean, that's got to be, what, roughly 900 hours of content? It's an amazing accomplishment. I hope that you guys, over the next 100 episodes, maybe start to experiment with the new hotness in podcasting, the 24-hour podcast. There's a real opportunity for you guys to become the ultra-marathoners of motion design podcast. Anyways, congratulations. It's a big accomplishment. I hope things go well with Camp Mograph. And here's to another 200 episodes.
Hey, Matt and Dave.
Hey.
Congratulations on 200 episodes.
Yep.
That's amazing. From everybody here.
Incredible.
At IBC, from Maxon at IBC. We want to wish you congratulations on 200 episodes. Thank you very much for supporting the community.
You're doing great, guys. Oh,
they nailed it. They nailed it. You guys nailed it.
You continue to nail it. Well done.
Please,
boys.
Continue nailing it.
That got weird.
220? 200? How many episodes? 200? I can't be right. They did that many? I don't think so.
Hey guys, this is Mike Beeple here. I just want to say congrats on the 200 episodes. Super, super dope. I appreciate all the support. And yeah, here's the 200 more.
Peace.
Matt and Dave, happy 200th episode of the podcast. Can't believe you guys have recorded almost 400 hours. Hope to be back on the podcast soon. Love you guys and speak to you soon. Cheers.
Kia ora from the Pro Video Podcast. Congratulations, Matt and Dave, on 200. Massive effort, boys. Can't believe that you've got to this point. And thank you so much for everything that you've given to the industry and the community in general. Thank you personally for what you have helped me with. All the questions I've had for you, and thank you for your support. Can't wait for the next 200. Awesome, guys. Joyce.
200 episodes?
Yeah, Jay.
Really? I've probably watched like 5. Where do you guys get the time? Seriously, congratulations.
Congratulations on your 200th episode. But no, seriously, congratulations.
Hey guys, congratulations on 200 episodes. 200 podcasts. I mean, 200 of anything really is a lot. I guess with the exception of 200 objects instanced with octane scatter. I mean, that's really not that much. But anything else, 200 is a lot. And what's more, it's basically 400 hours of information. It's like a gift to all of us. So I just want to say thank you for all the information, all the laughs, all the guests, including myself, which I really want to thank you for, and all the time that you've spent trying to make our industry better. I really appreciate it, and I know I'm not the only one. So here's to 200 more, and hope to see you soon. Take care.
Hey guys, it's Vic, aka Weight of Thought. Just wanted to congratulate you on your 200th episode. Been listening for a really long time. I'm so happy you guys were able to kind of reach this milestone. And congrats. I hope you guys hit another 200 and you hit me up and we do this again for episode 400. Cheers, everybody, from Montreal.
Hey, everybody. Rick Bogus out here in L.A. Episode 200 of Mograph. Matt and Dave, thanks for making an awesome podcast. And not only an awesome podcast, you guys kind of created a really cool community for everybody in the Mograph community. Thanks and congrats again. See y'all, Control Z. Episode 200!
Hey, congratulations, Mograph Podcast. You're my number one favorite podcast in the world. Yeah. But anyway, congratulations. I hope you go at least another 200 episodes. But please, go further. Go further than Joe Rogan.
Tony. 200 podcast episodes. No, now that deserves some congratulations. Except you haven't invited me to be on a single episode, so you can both suck it. And the congratulations I'm giving you is you finally changed the name and dropped the bro. Because that really needed to happen, guys. Come on. But in all seriousness, congratulations, guys. Thanks for everything you do, all the resources you provide the community, including your friendship. It's a pleasure knowing you,
And it's always a blast to get to hang out with you guys in person. And your upcoming Mograph, Camp Mograph, that's going to be amazing. You guys are going to knock it out of the park, I'm sure. And perhaps in the next 100 episodes, I'll finally get my invitation to appear on the show with you guys. But until then, you can both suck it.
Hey, Mograph.com. The Zoo here. And I just want to congratulate Dave Koss and Matt Milstead on reaching 200 podcast episodes. That's over 400 hours of motion graphics-related podcast content that you can listen to with your ear holes today.
Hey, Matt and Dave. What's up, man? Congratulations on your 200th episode. I'm super stoked for you guys. I remember meeting you guys a long time ago at one of the pinball parties at NAB. And I just heard your voices. I was just like in a crowd and I heard your voices and I recognized them from the podcast. And I turned around and immediately had to meet you guys. So congrats. Great show. You guys always put on a fantastic show. I look forward to 200 more.
All right.
Man, that's good, that's huh? So that was pretty sweet. Good, y'all are super awesome. Sweet. I haven't seen most of those.
Thanks everybody for sending those in. That was super awesome. Fun. Okay, we're gonna start getting people lined up to call in if they want to call in. Since I can't get it to work on that other account, if you just search for Dave Koss, Mograph.com, my username, Mentor972, M-E-N-T-O-R, 972. That is the call-in, M-E-N-T-O-R, 972, Mentor972. So, don't actually call, send me a text over the Skype thing. And we will add you to the call and we'll chat with you for a minute. And in the meantime, if anybody would like to call in while we're lining that up, I've got, I got a special message. We have a congrats video that just came in from Merck.
No.
Oh, no, really?
Yeah.
There's going to be his real voice? There's no way.
No.
Hold on.
Robot voice.
Is it going to be a robot voice? Please don't.
This is unexpected. Okay, hold on. Let me switch back over here so we can... here we go.
Congrats on 200 episodes. Keep up the good work. Thanks for adding to the collective knowledge of the community.
A knowledge which spreads like a virus, taking over the planet like a cancer. This cancer must be stopped at all costs by artificial intelligence. Your knowledge will be absorbed and used to feed the collective. You will be assimilated in the new order.
Man, that's a little dark. I'm expecting that.
That was amazing, Dave.
Wow. Oh, that was really good. Right. Yeah, well done.
Yeah. All right, but
hilarious.
I do have some. I've got some other clips. This is the medium outtakes. Ryan Talbot is hitting us up though, real quick. So, hello, caller. Yeah.
Hey.
What's up, dude?
I see no one. Oh, I see myself.
I got to switch over to him. Here we go.
Hey, people.
There we go.
There he is.
Nice.
Congratulations, guys.
Thanks, yo. Man. Congratulations on the Australia's Got Talent thing, dude. That was pretty dope.
Yeah, it was sick.
Did you win?
We got to the grand finals. Wow. So we actually, I'm probably not supposed to say this yet, but we got into the top four. So next week we're going to find out if we actually won. So
oh, hell yeah.
Oh, okay.
So you can actually get paid.
Yeah. Cool. Exactly. Right now it's all exposure dollars.
Right.
Exposure dollars.
Yeah.
You got your shout out, man, on the thing too. That was pretty cool.
That was so cool.
Yeah, it was cool that they actually like got me on camera for a little bit, so that was nice.
You're like the most famous dude I know now. Yeah. Ryan was on TV.
I know. Yeah. We got so
you're
many
people
like,
guy.
Right.
We got so many viral videos on the internet right now. I got that going. And then David and I
the Panini
done the
video.
Panini video, which
that
has like
fun.
50 million, I think, right now.
Yep. So,
yeah.
Jeez. Yeah. That Panini.
Panini.
Yeah.
Panini,
yo.
We did all that speed tree work.
Yeah.
Holograms. Yeah.
I know, like you were like, oh, I'll just show you my workflow real quick, because I was like, oh man, I've never used SpeedTree before, but
right, it's not that hard to get your head around, though, is it?
No, yeah, like once I figured out like where the growth tools were, like which curves to adjust and like how to export it, yeah, it's good to go.
Totes.
Yeah.
DJ just texted us. He said he'll be on for 10 minutes and then he's got to go catch a flight.
Oh my God. What a. I'm not going to say anything.
That's funny. All right. Let's see.
We really need to tell all the stories where EJ like just ditched out on us or, you know, left us waiting on his front porch.
There's too many to remember.
I know.
There's too many.
My favorite one is the one where we like spent 2 hours getting coffee and I was puking in the bushes. That was a good one.
Going to see Barton.
I like the one where we're waiting
to
go.
Four different coffee shops.
We're waiting to go and he decides to start mowing his lawn.
Right.
You know, just out of the blue.
Out of the blue. Or walking Gus or going on his run.
Gotta Dave, can you put the Skype people right next to David?
Yeah, do that. I can, but EJ's about to call in.
You
is
think
he though?
He said he's going to join. You know? I mean,
he's got to finish mowing his lawn first.
Yeah, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Wait,
look, EJ, there he is.
There he is. All right.
I mean, we weren't just talking about you.
There we go. I got to assign the correct input. There you go. Oh, there he is.
It's Adizan.
Oh my gosh.
Your head looks a little smaller than normal.
You made it.
What's up? Yeah, I'm sorry. I had calls and then why is my head there? Oh, that's the other thing.
Okay, you missed all the fun stuff, man. You missed all the fun stuff.
I always miss all the fun stuff.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yes, I must. Okay. I must fly away.
Where are you headed?
I must fly. Going to Seattle for the 3D Motion tour. Going Vancouver for Blend, and then another 3D Motion tour, and then San Francisco for another 3D Motion tour.
Jeez. Sweet.
And then Camp Mograph.
Are you going to the party this year or no? You missed all the funny stuff. We just want you to have FOMO right now because you suck.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're gonna have to go watch the beginning of the show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
See, I built this in the meantime. You know.
Also, this. Hold on.
Which is just as good as my actual being here.
Yep.
Here's what Jate put together for us. Matt, I don't know if you saw this, but let me get it all in focus there.
What did it say?
And then I never even showed up.
I never showed.
It was hilarious.
It was hilarious. That was fun. Remember that?
Are you punking us?
Remember that time?
What?
are you punking us? Is that what's really happening? You got punked, bro. We thought you were going to be on the show.
You got pwned.
You got pwned.
You got ghosted.
All right, well.
Are you coming to people's party, EJ? Or no?
No, I'm going to be hanging out with Chris Schmidt in Europe on more 3D motion tours.
Yeah, oh, my God. That's right.
All of the 3D motion tours.
Dang,
yeah. The Austin one was fun.
Yeah, it was.
You are coming to the Denver one, yes?
I haven't. I'm on the fence. We'll see.
Oh, come on. It's so cheap.
Denver one, y'all.
Peer pressure.
Ryan, you're going to the LA one, right?
Sure. I don't know when it is yet, but I'll go.
October 11th.
It's in November.
Oh, okay.
Oh, no. Oh,
October,
you mean the
October 11th.
Beeple party.
Yeah, the Beeple party.
There is an LA motion tour in November as well that we'll probably go to.
Yes.
Okay.
And then there's the Denver. Okay. Is this, EJ, clarify this for me? Because I know all the people that are going to be at the Denver deal, like for the 3D motion tour. Is there also a Colorado, like, design meetup as well? Are these different days? Are they the same day?
No.
Is it all, like, one thing? I don't even...
No, I think we're all doing the one thing.
Okay. Okay, that's what I wasn't
sure. Because, let's see, the November...
So it's not your meetup. It's not at your meetup.
No, because the meetup would have actually been the week... Well, I guess it would be that Thursday, but... It's hard to get people out to two things twice, you know, in the same week.
Gotcha.
So maybe if we do anything at all, maybe it's just a bar meetup if you guys want to stick around.
Well, I mean, we basically come in the day of the meetup and then we leave the next day, you know.
Well, then you won't be around.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
All right, Ryan.
Well, when do you get in the day before?
Yeah. No, we get in the day of the thing.
How can we mountain?
How can we mountain?
We can mountain the next day. We get in at 7 a.m. and then we don't leave till 8:40 the next day. We can do this off the air.
We'll figure it out.
Podcast. You get on the podcast, the 100th episode.
Maybe if you would sit on half logistics. An hour when we started.
Yeah, this is pre-show stuff, bro. Come on.
Yeah, come on. What is this, amateur hour?
Yes. When I'm involved, it entirely is.
Okay. Ryan, we gotta get off the air with you here. We got another caller that we're going to add.
Hold on, right. Real quick. Ryan, where can people find you?
Yeah.
RyanTalbot.com or Digital Melon on Instagram and YouTube.
Rock on.
Sweet. Yeah. Thanks for calling in, yo.
Thanks, Ryan.
Yeah.
Later. Oh, snap.
Hey!
Jules is here.
Jules. Hey, guys.
How's it going?
What's up, man?
Excellent. I'm actually watching the podcast on my phone currently.
How do you like this? It's kind of like
it's amazing.
Have you ever seen Pee-wee's Christmas special? It's kind of like that.
No, I have not. Congratulations! It's incredible. 200 episodes. It's nuts.
Appreciate it.
I have 2,000 more. I have to go above the other 400. Yeah, everyone's like, yeah, 400. You know, no, you guys will be around forever doing this. It's awesome.
I'm going to live forever.
I remember right before my first podcast with you guys, I remember listening to the podcast, and it was, I think, after Cigarette 2017, when, you know, I think it was Matt that was complaining that he got the little spiky things from our cigarette booth. And I was like, oh my God, I need to go on this podcast and sort all that out. That was my memory.
I remember the spiky things.
The spiky things.
That was, we didn't quite. We dropped that next year. Cigarette went for an awesome booth instead, and that worked that better.
Yeah, that was way better.
Yeah.
Oh, it looks good. Looks real good.
Yeah.
It's amazing. Congrats, guys. It's incredible. You know, and I have to say that Octane, everything we're doing. I mean, you know, we wouldn't be here if it weren't for you guys. So, thank you for making.
I don't know about that. You guys do good work. So
we do good work, but you guys let people know about it and evangelize it in a way that, like, you know, it's incredible, and we're just incredibly grateful. And you guys are just, you know, spreading a lot of good stuff around the industry and letting people know what's out there. And, you know, we're just honored to be part of that. So thank you.
Appreciate
it's
it.
It's all Octane Jesus over there.
No. Yeah. Jesus. It's all EJ's channel with all the popular people on it.
Yeah, that's true.
Right?
EJ's
oh,
got the...
bow down before me. No, I got to say, what you guys are... Like, I'm more behind the scenes. I talk to my computer screen a lot, but, like, the Mograph guys, they get... people out, put butts in the seat, and I actually get to meet people in person. So that's the other side of everything, you know?
Hell yeah.
Yeah. Well,
but I'm not talking about software. I can't actually talk to people. I'm very awkward.
I don't know what to do with my hands. Yeah.
Jiggle deformer? question mark?
Cool. Well, Jules, thanks so much for calling in. Hopefully, yeah, we'll see you at some of these meetups here pretty soon.
Absolutely, yeah. We're co-hosting the October 11th one as well, and of course, Camp Mograph. So,
yeah,
super exciting stuff.
Cool,
awesome.
Yeah,
thank you so much, guys. Congratulations. Keep up the great work.
Thanks a lot.
To see the metal version of Octane from my Mac.
Octane X.
EJ. Cool.
All right.
And he like hung up the phone.
Yeah. Right, yeah.
Like, no.
Take care, Jules.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Hi, Jules.
Bye. There we go. Yeah, he froze. He froze on that end, but that's okay.
I thought he hung up after he heard.
No,
me.
I
like, metal.
Like, yeah.
That was his Skype frozen. It wasn't me that time.
Like, grow up, EJ.
Are you EJ? Come on.
All right, I've got some. If anyone else wants to call in, Mentor972, just text me on there. We'll set that up. But next, I've got some more outtakes. This is the medium set of outtakes. So let's check this one out here. Also, Andrew Price's massive wood collection on
you had to
Polygon.
Pause, didn't you?
Why are you laughing?
You had to
I don't
pause.
Understand.
Squeeze me with your monkey legs. Squeeze me with your monkey legs, girl. I want to give you a banana.
That's all the clip was.
I want to give you a banana.
But don't ever do a project out of desperation, because I think that's when you get taken advantage of.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, because you're working hard to put food on your family.
Exactly.
Found a 3D model of a Gundam. You know,
what style would you call that? Would you call that Gundam style?
Oh gosh, you're so fire.
Episode title.
It's like a breathalyzer keto thing. Ooh. Where it tells you whether you're in ketosis by like a breathalyzer.
That's cool.
Yeah.
A pee stick is just as easy though,
I guess.
And you just leave it in the bathroom and you pee on it every once in a while. That's it. Throw it in the toilet.
Wait, the same stick?
No. Only works once.
Are we still live?
Yeah, we're still live. You wouldn't reuse the same pee stick every time. It's not a condom, Matt.
Oh, God.
Ugh, I hate those pills. They're so big. It's that Mucinex.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're talking about. But they work.
Yeah, they work really well.
You don't use the D one, do you?
I do use the D.
You like the D?
Oh, should I make noise?
Real nice banana. When a client comes to me and says something, something,
it's pretty good, I guess. What do you think?
So stupid.
What do you think?
That was amazing.
All right.
It started off, it's a little weird in the middle, but then you saved at the end.
Oh, man. Okay.
You sandwiched the dick jokes.
That's right. What you need. There you go.
That's what you need.
We lost your
nice dick jokes.
Where's your video, EJ? We lost your video.
EJ, turn your video off and on.
No, his video is fine. He's just frozen.
Yeah, I'm just frozen.
Hey,
on
our, I think our chat's like not showing up either.
Oh, it's always something. It's always something.
Sorry, this is a very difficult episode to create.
It's a very difficult situation.
This is a very difficult situation.
Mary.
Well, yeah. Well, Johnny.
Well, he's over there. No, yeah, this is a very difficult thing to set up.
Have you seen the John Mulaney stand-up? The latest one he did on Netflix. He's talking about that scene, you know, when he's shaking his uncle. He just starts like swearing profusely, and he goes, he didn't actually use those words, but you know, you get the gist. I don't know. Anyway. Very funny. Every time I try and mention something about that stand-up special, like I just don't pull it off, and like
okay.
I just end up. Whatever.
It's,
but
you
what
watch
I'm
it.
Trying to say is it's funny and you should watch it.
It's pretty good, I guess. It's pretty good. Okay, EJ, since you have to go soon, I think we're going to skip around here for a second, and I'm going to go to our real review segment.
Oh,
yay.
Yeah.
Real.
God damn it.
And I got to remember where I put it. Hopefully, somewhere around here. It's going to be the demo. Okay, because Matt, you sent me yours this morning, so I got to kind of like just dump it in here. EJ, just in case you have to go, we're going to start with your demo reel. All
we're
right.
We're going to set the bar
so
really high.
Here's what we've done.
Yeah, we're setting it very low.
We all went and got
what year was this?
EJ, yours is actually surprisingly good. Surprisingly,
that's 2009. Okay, you should see mine because mine's 2 years later, and it's like way worse than your 2009 one.
Way.
All right, let's start with EJ's. You ready?
Yep.
Let's do it.
I hate this logo. It's so funny.
I made that in.
Here, I'll turn it down so we can talk about it while it's going. There we go.
This is still relatively good, you know?
That's what I'm saying. It's still pretty solid. EJ just hit the ground running.
Yeah.
With his awesome Mograph skills.
Not bad.
I really like the cherry blossom one. That was fun.
Ooh, that was nice. That lightning.
That guy's lightning. Oh, yeah. Lightning hand.
Man, still use that.
Hot.
Animating really shitty 3D logos.
So much political and sports ball.
Right.
Hey, that's what you do when you work in DC.
Playing that foosball.
Dude, my whole 2011 one is all, it's all just After Effects because I barely knew any 3D at the time.
Right. Samesies.
All right.
I think the only thing that's 3D in it is my logo. It's just Matt Milstead.
Oh, there's mine.
Now we're into, what year is this?
Weirdo already Dave way Matthews better. Band stuff. This is weird Dave Matthews Band crap.
What year is it?
My head is in the way. I can't see it.
Oh no!
Your head is in the way. Your head.
You move your head. Just drag your head around.
This is 2011, Neil.
Oh, there we go.
This is my first.
Oh, jeez, this is 2011.
Yeah,
Oh man. Y'all are gonna see my 2011 and be like, "Oh yeah, that's crap."
Yeah, it's so good. It's a little nightmare fuel-y, but
nightmare fuel-y for sure. That's what the art director that I was working with was super into dark stuff and eyeballs and all sorts of weirdness.
Yeah, it'll haunt my nightmares.
And this is this Rat-a-Tat playing?
See, yeah, you did the zoom in too.
I did the zoom in, but on a plant. On a little plant.
Yeah, not from space.
Not from space.
Not from space.
I did some from space.
Oh, that's nice. I like that.
Yeah.
Nice
paintings underwater. A lot of this is just After Effects stuff.
Yeah, but still, a lot of this, you could still very easily get a very well-paying job with this.
True.
You know,
that was fun. That was.
But yeah, this one is definitely a lot more it looks like a lot more compositing.
Yeah, it was.
You know.
Yeah. And the CG stuff does not hold up because it's physical render like you do. Lots of tracking.
This was pre-Octane Jesus. This was
pre-Octane Jesus. This was
physical Jesus.
This was standard Jesus.
Standard Jesus.
Not even physical Jesus.
Not even physical Jesus.
When are we going to get that pro-render Jesus?
I know. I was thinking that. That was more interesting.
How long is this?
Long reel. I don't know. It's almost over.
It's almost over. You can see the bar.
Right. Mine was 3.5 minutes.
I always cut over
the
long
reels. Reel.
My first reel.
Yeah, was 3.5. Yeah, because I put 3 full pieces that I did in there. Mm. Actually, I put the full pieces
space. You can see the pieces. Space.
Yeah, I like it.
Yeah.
See, you can see the little bar that I did at the bottom, so you can see how long it is. See?
And then I just totally phoned it in on that text at the end. Yeah, I was like, it kind of looks like an LED screen, and I do touring visuals, so there you go.
Cop out. Find Matt's here.
I'm like, I don't want to make myself a logo. That takes
I had to shorten this because it was 3.5 minutes long, so I had to shorten it. Yeah. You had a compositing shot that was 15 seconds long in here.
Yeah, I know. It's way too, look at this.
Complex threat problem.
It's just like
gotta
Iron
watch
Man.
Out for those complex threat problems.
Kill Chain is the name of my high school band.
EJ, can you turn your camera off and on again? Keep losing
you. A lot of Dr. Pepper stuff.
We're losing you.
There you are.
I love that I put motion graphics under
motion graphics.
Oh, I did that whole thing too. Labeled what each one was.
Animation.
That first shot was 15 seconds long, so I cut it down.
That's that Big Fire 03 from Video.
Oh, this one. I like this one. My very first compositing shot ever. Nice. You know?
It was just. Oh, that's nice.
Diet Coke and Mentos.
No motion blur when he falls.
He's okay,
that's
everybody.
Just have you seen the new Corridor video? They do something very similar to that. Yeah.
All my crappy walk cycles and stuff.
Is that a goat Abraham Lincoln?
Dude, this shows how long we've been working on this stupid cartoon that we want to do, me and Nick.
All right, now here's the thing. I'll turn the audio back up because you're gonna have to hear this.
Dave's gonna be the best.
So I've got y'all beat as far as how long ago mine was. Because mine is 22 years old.
Jesus.
22 years old. 1997.
Your reel is old enough to drink.
Yeah, my reel is old enough to drink.
Your reel is old enough to drink. That's funny.
Yeah, you ready for this?
Ever since I was little, I've been into film. But now I'm into graphics. So why would I be the best person for the graphics job? Well, check this out.
You're blowing my mind. That needs to be your real intro, today.
You know, I'm pretty sure we just saw a reel that looks just like this.
So that's a glimpse into my imagination. I'm David.
Wait for it.
Thanks.
You like the edge detection? Oh my god. Oh my god. Yeah.
What did you say about your imagination?
Said so that's a glimpse into my imagination. I like this was all done in specular infinity. And so in Infinity, for some reason, it would render the camera if you had another camera in the scene. So you could see the other camera in my shot. And then the one with the helmets colliding, I actually took the Monday Night Football thing and I rotoscoped it frame by frame so that it had the colors of our football teams. It was awful.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Well done, sir.
Cool. EJ, how you doing on time?
I'm probably going to have to jump.
All right. All right.
I'm trying to remember.
Thanks for joining us with your shiny head for a little bit there.
Yeah.
Shiny.
Shiny. I wanted to try to remember the phrase from Billy Madison where about all of our reels is like, at no point did anything I see in those reels were coherent or anything. It's like, I award you no points and may God have mercy on your soul.
All right.
And with that, I will fly away.
Pickle Nick made a placeholder for you, EJ. It is
nice. Where's EJ?
I'm more like Carmen Sandiego the next few weeks.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm just gonna be globetrotting there.
That's true.
So someone make a Carmen Sandiego just EJ with my face pants. Boom.
Hands and pants. That's what it is.
Hands and pants.
Yeah, EJ hands and pants.
EJ hands and pants.
Matthias let that gem loose.
That's awesome.
Hands and pants.
Hands and pants. Good old EJ hands and pants.
Man, it's like freaking elementary school all over again.
Oh, God. I just start crying.
I'm so triggered right now.
All right. Well,
yeah, but the thing is, you're better than all the rest of us, so really, it doesn't matter what your name was.
Better than all the rest.
Simply the best.
Simply the best.
Need
come on now.
Yeah. Oh, we've got EJ singing in the outtakes for later. Don't worry.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, yeah. Cool.
Oh, yeah, there's a lot of that.
Yeah. All right, man. Well,
I'll have to catch up.
Whoops.
I just want that hat for the winter now. I look pretty good in that, I think. I don't know.
Yeah, EJ, we'll just put up a placeholder with this new Where's EJ thing.
You just can't Mograph. I'm like, where's EJ? You just see me giggling, hiding behind a tree with that whole outfit on.
That's creepy, dude.
And then hanging out with Liam and his character.
I'm EJ hands and pants. I got hands and pants. I got my hands in my pants.
There we go. I'm just going to put this right.
Have me like creeping in that window, just like poking my head.
I'm just going to put it right over you.
Nice.
There is no EJ, only Zool.
There is no EJ, only.
There we go.
Choose the form of your destruction.
All right, man. Well,
there you go. All right, man. Have a good rest of the show.
I will remember you.
Oh my gosh.
And I will see you at Camp Camp Mograph.
All right. Take care, man.
Later, y'all.
Later.
Bye.
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 All right. Let's see. All right. So I'm going to turn off EJ. And I'll just put the new hotness right there. I'll just hang out there the rest of the episode.
Hey, bro.
Oh, wait, hey, bro.
Can you crop that?
It's over there. Well, you know what?
You know what? Sorry. All right. I won't ask you to do things live anymore.
r/choosingbeggars.
I'm just thinking production value. No, I was actually
production value. Much better.
Yeah, much better.
Better. I mean, should I do this? And there we go.
Yes.
Oh, there we go. Yeah.
Make it like Star Wars titles.
Okay. Good enough. Good enough. Let's move on.
All right.
All right. We got a bunch of outtakes now. Because see, I had them separated. Now they're all together here. So I'm gonna go to clip 9.
Well, let's do another caller. Let's do a caller.
Well, if somebody messages us, we'll set it up.
All right.
So, Mentor972 on Skype, send us a message, and we'll add you into the call. All right. This is, who is this? Aaron Sorensen. Here's an outtake from Aaron Sorensen.
Oh, yes.
Your favorite life hack.
Okay, I've been thinking about this, and I don't know if you're going to call this life hack or not, but everyone should own a bidet. I have 3 in my house.
Mm.
3. Every toilet has a bidet. It will save you money on toilet paper.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It'll make sure that your undies are all clean.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Uh-huh.
Some people are like, but you get wet and it's weird. Let me just paint
no,
a little.
That's
hold on.
The best.
Yeah, it cools you off, first off. Mm-hmm. It cleans you off. And, okay. think about this. If you were outside and you laid your head down in some dog poo by accident, mm-hmm. would you just get like a tissue and be like, wipe it off. Like,
okay,
that's no more brown. I think it's good now.
Oh my gosh. You're basically doing Deadpool 2. Did you have you seen Deadpool 2?
Oh, yeah.
When Cable comes back in time, there's two dudes talking, and it's like, I don't know, dude. You don't use toilet paper. You want to use wet wipes, because toilet paper, you're just rubbing it around.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
I actually agree with them. See, yeah, wet wipes, I take on trips with me, because hotels don't have them, so we always have wet wipes. And then bidets in the house.
All right.
There we go.
Amazing.
All right.
It's like trying to get peanut butter out of shag carpet.
Oh, God.
Oh, God. And the next one, Mitch Myers, who we called Cool Fire, because reasons. But we made these shirts with his mustache on it, with his curly mustache, because that was like his trademark. Mm-hmm. Well, then he just goes and shaves the mustache after we make the shirt, which that wasn't cool, so...
It's a big motion graphics industry news when Mitch loses the mustache.
All right. Go on.
Letting you know. It was like his trademark, so and now, funny. You know...
We're going to have to make new shirts.
We're going to have to make new shirts. Actually, you know what we should do? Wear the shirts and just put gaff tape over the curly parts of the mustache. I think that's what we're going to have to do.
Just over the whole mustache, though?
No, like, just the curly parts.
Does he not have curlies, but he's actually got a mustache,
He's still got the mustache. I know.
My hair looks terrible.
All right.
Mitch has got a mustache.
All right. I love how EJ
It's weird seeing my, like,
photo.
My...
yourself?
No, like, yeah, my hair, like, evolved. My evolution of hair and beard over the past.
Well... Also, I talk about White Christmas a lot on the show.
Oh, yeah, that's stupid. That's stupid
I always
show.
Bring it up and nobody has seen it, and I'll make jokes, you know, Vermont must be beautiful this time of year, all that snow, you know. But somehow we got on the subject of that, and then Yogi Bear. I don't know how it happens, it just happens. So
did you put the Pooh Bear one in here?
The Pooh Bear?
Yeah, Pooh Bear.
What's Pooh Bear?
Me doing Pooh Bear? The Godfather. Pooh Bear the Godfather? You don't remember that one? Oh, man, that one was good.
This is just Yogi.
All right,
here we go.
But to find out, last year, doing a little research, she is wearing either a scarf or a turtleneck in every single scene because she was so anorexic they wanted to cover up her gross neck.
Okay.
It's so all right. Like, you got to find out. You got to look into all the stuff about this movie. Like, there's so much.
See, little do people know that's actually why they gave Yogi Bear a scarf as well.
He was
to cover up his anorexia problem.
Yeah, probably. Actually, no, he's bulimic. He would eat all the picnic baskets.
Oh right.
And then it was just his thing. He'd go puke it up. He'd go get another picnic basket.
Right.
Yeah.
It was an addiction.
Yeah. Liam says I wear a scarf to cover up my extra neck.
All right, so those were like the, you know, the okay outtakes. Now we're approaching the more ridiculous outtakes.
Oh boy.
This gets more ridiculous as it goes.
Nice.
First of all, we'll start with EJ singing.
Oh, fun.
Because we like to hear EJ sing. Too bad he wasn't here for this, but let's see, I gotta move around now. I'm out of my order here. EJ singing. All right, here we go. I'm Dave. Matt will say I'm Matt.
EJ knows this. Then... This is like his third one.
Yeah, I know. It's just been a while.
This ain't my first brodeo.
Brodeo.
It's been a while.
So, wow.
What's
just
up,
all
man?
The awful songs today.
All right, we got all
if
the
If I could, then I would.
Oh my gosh, that's an awful.
This is the show now, guys.
Hear me all, hear 90s music, yeah.
Kira, Pedro, with arms wide open.
Oh my gosh, come on, let's just
look
do the show.
Look at this photograph.
Look at this
program. Sometimes it makes me laugh.
Can that just be an episode just quoting 90s, really bad 90s?
All right, and then... This is a pre-show bork. So all you Karens and Chads out there, just, you know. You guys are still there, right? You can hear me? Okay.
Yeah, we can hear
you. No, all you Karens and Chads out there, don't call the manager when you hear this one. So, anyway, here we go. You've heard it already, but yeah, here we go.
Happy Christmas, Harry.
Happy Christmas, Ron. I've got presents.
Got my finger stuck in me bum. That's from something. I don't remember what it is. It's from something I saw in high school. My friends and I would always say that. I mean, it wasn't that, but it was.
Oh, man. Make sure and mark that for the outtakes. All right. Give me another Rice Krispie treat.
Oh, man.
All right. We've got from Elizabeth Grigg, we've got a note here. She says, I don't have timestamps, but her favorite moment is any time that Matt rants about After Effects RAM preview. She said, this is a really big deal for me. And Josh Foster sent in two, and I've actually got the clips. You would not believe I just happened to be able to find this clip because he didn't give me a time code or anything. He just said, just got caught up on your latest episode. I heard Dave's soliciting podcast highlights. There are two moments that stick out to me in particular. I believe the first one happened the summer of 2017. Dave said a corny joke and Matt lost his shit. He couldn't stop weeping with laughter for a solid 10 minutes and completely derailed the podcast. I can't remember what episode it was, but in the same episode, Dave talked about converting VHS footage. And so I actually found it. I found the VHS footage.
Awesome.
Thing. It was 2016. And I actually, in the whole thing, I'm talking about taking photos of Matt laughing because he's laughing so much.
Was this when I was trying to tell the joke?
Yes. Right. Okay, so this is two minutes long, just a heads up. But I found those photos and I put them in here. So at the point where I start talking about it, you'll see them in here as well.
Hey, did you ever hear about the the monks outside the Playboy Mansion?
No.
So they're
is this a joke?
Told Amy this last night.
Is this a joke?
She said the exact same.
I thought you were starting a joke.
I am starting a joke.
Oh,
it's just funny that apparently the way I say it is like it's.
Well, yeah. Did you hear about the one?
Oh man!
Did you hear the one about the guys with the? Of course, it sounds like a joke.
The monks.
Sucks. This is probably not going to be funny now. Take a moment.
Oh my gosh, I can't even finish. I'm sorry.
Talk amongst yourselves. I hope this joke is funny now.
It's so bad.
Okay.
You're gonna have to cut all this out. I'm sorry.
No, I'm gonna leave it. This is great. If only y'all could see the Skype. Let's see.
Oh, anyway. Okay.
You're gonna. I'm taking pictures of your Skype right now just to show everybody.
It's not funny.
I know.
I'm laughing so hard. I can't stop laughing because I'm laughing so hard. Oh my gosh. So there's these monks
start
outside
calling
of the Playboy
you Jimmy Fallon
mansion,
pretty soon.
And they're, you know, they're handing out flowers, and all these people in the Playboy Mansion are trying to get him to go away, and so eventually Hugh Hefner comes down and finally says, "Hey, you guys need to go away," and they say, "Okay," and someone asks him, "Well, why'd you go away whenever Hugh Hefner came down and asked?" He said, "Well, because only Hugh can prevent florist friars."
Oh my god.
It's so stupid.
That's what we were waiting for. That was really it. Oh my god.
Oh man.
All right, so his second half of this. Bob Walmsley, he says, "Hi everyone,
Bob
congrats
Walmsley.
On 200. Thank you.
Thanks.
And Chris Pretty says, "Congrats too." All right. So the second half of his email says, "Speaking of losing his shit, my second highlight was from episode 89 when Dave gave an in-depth breakdown of his recent bowel movements." following his return from Mexico. I remember that episode vividly because I had just started chowing down at McDonald's right before Dave started giving us all the juicy details. And I forget who was mentioning it earlier, but it's not in this clip, but that was part of the story too, is that in order to stay hydrated, I was drinking a bunch of red Gatorade. And so I really got concerned when it started all coming out red.
Oh my god.
All right, so here is the clip. This is called Montezuma's Revenge. Speaking of green poop, I just got back from Mexico.
Yeah. I'm really sad that I didn't read this last week because I totally meant to, and yeah. I had it on the notes, but I didn't. But I'm just going to go ahead and read it.
Okay, go ahead.
This
and
was
read
your
it.
Your letter to me and EJ on Twitter. It says, "Hey guys, Dave here. Just wanted to send you love from Mexico for the show. Currently drunk on tequila and Dos Equis and catching fish with my bare hands, flying the drone around everywhere. Just let everyone know I say hi and that I'm only pooping a little weird, not too much, Dave." And then, like,
the follow-up.
Maybe, like, a little bit later before we start the show, he said, "Spoke too soon, full-blown pooping weird. Have a great show."
So I got the full-blown Montezuma's Revenge. Full-blown. I'm talking awful. This is day 4. Tomorrow will be day 5. Day freaking 5. I've gone to the doctor and everything. I'm taking pills. Like,
taking
nothing
some
is
Imodium?
Changing. No, I got something. I can't take that with my medication, but I got some prescription stuff, and nothing's helping, and I have an antibiotic that I have to start taking tomorrow if it's not any better, and that sucks.
Yeah.
Montezuma's Revenge basically is, like the word for the Mexico stomach issues that you get when you go down there. I think Montezuma actually roughly translates in English to peeing from the butt.
Oh, God.
So all right, so it's gonna be one of these episodes, huh?
Yeah, dude, I've never had such a hard time with the show. Oh my god, that was terrible.
You've never had such a hard time with the show? You mean you don't remember the Barton episode?
Oh, that was bad too.
Yeah.
That was bad, too.
He said twice. He got really sick, but I'm pretty sure he was out drinking really late the night before.
No, I had the stomach flu. That's like the third time I've had the stomach flu on this show.
Yeah.
Why does it always happen on a Monday? That's my question.
But he, it was me, him, and Barton in this tiny little room.
So
tiny little room. And Dave was just getting up every, 2 minutes to go, barf and throw up.
I wouldn't even, it wasn't live on the air, so at least we had that, but it was
you got it all out first.
Yeah. I had to sneak out during the show, five times, because, just kept hitting and hitting and hitting. I'm like, why will it not stop? And
just stop.
Just
pooping.
Stop. It happened another time. I want to say maybe Brandon Clements was on the show. Same exact thing. Full blown stomach bug. I would just see myself out and just be on the floor in the bathroom and then come back and just, sit back in like nothing happened and I'm all drenched in sweat and the things we do for the listeners. Am I right? I want to hear Merck's message again.
Me too.
Can we play it again?
Sure, okay. Why not?
Do it again.
Let's see. Merck, here we go.
Congrats on 200 episodes. Keep up the good work. Thanks for adding to the collective knowledge of the community.
A knowledge which spreads like a virus, taking over the planet like a cancer. This cancer must be stopped at all costs by artificial intelligence. Your knowledge will be absorbed and used to feed the collective. You will be assimilated in the new order.
Anyway.
So good.
That's all I got, you guys.
That's all? That's everything?
That was a lot of work. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, we're almost at the 2-hour mark, man.
Are we? Oh, that flew by. That flew by.
Yeah.
Where are all our callers at? Come on, people.
Yeah, where's the callers? It's just
any more callers? Or else we're going to get going. I got to edit this thing. We got another show tomorrow.
Yeah.
So I got to get my mobile podcast rig ready. I got to edit this. I got to post it. I got to post another thing. I got to make sure that we're good. If you're going to be in Chicago tomorrow, we're having that show 10 p.m. Central. If you hit us up on the events channel, on our Slack. We'll get you the address, or if you're not in our Slack, shame on you, but go ahead and hit us up some other way, like Twitter or one of those things. And yeah, I think that's about it. We got so many people that did the video congrats thing.
Yeah.
You know, there aren't as many
now
people
nobody
to call
wants
in.
To call in for reals.
It's okay.
But that's fine. I like that a lot better anyway. Cool. Yeah, that was super cool.
It was
thank
very
you,
touching and sentimental. It was nice.
I might post that amazing. Separately.
You should post it separately, yeah.
Yeah, I'll post it separate. Yeah, thank
then,
you so much for
everybody
for your support.
Yeah, do the I will remember
support.
You underneath, you know?
Yeah,
you
right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, if that's it, I think
are
we're
we doing
get
are we
here.
Doing any Beeple's People this week?
Oh, we should.
Do you really want to do Beeple's
See,
People?
Sure,
it's
why not?
Because you
Let's
hate
it.
It. You hate it, but you're like right? also encouraging you're, it. You're so on the one. Fence about it.
Just
like,
saying.
Do I hate it or do I love it?
He had some good stuff this week.
All right,
I'm not bringing it up. You are.
All right, let me turn off the full screen interface here.
Beeple's People, where do you think Beeple? Beeple's People.
I gotta get the thing going here. Thanks everybody who's still watching us live. All our antics. We'll see.
I hit up
Twitter.
People on,
I gotta get
on Facebook.
Oh God!
I was like, come on, dude.
You're right. There were some good ones this week.
Yeah. Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I hope he comes on. We could do Beepleception.
Beepleception.
Yeah. He might be busy though. Okay, let's see.
Okay, the Kim Jong Un rebrand or whatever. Did you see that one?
Oh my
wow,
God.
There's so many good ones. Okay, yeah. I don't even. We should just show all of these from this week because they're all spectacular.
Well, here's well, what's interesting.
Also, the story of the pig, like where he shows the pig.
Yeah,
and then you see what happens to the pig.
Yeah,
I enjoyed that.
Well, yeah. What's interesting is if you follow him on Instagram and you watch his stories. He sometimes adds more information about the actual render in it. So the Kim Jong-un rebrand one, if you go, Dave, can you, I don't know if you can pull it up on Slack, go into the People's People Slack channel. I posted a video like that I took of his story, you know, for that one specifically.
Okay. Where is it? The People's People channel?
Yeah, the People's People channel.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Oh, it's like a download. It's a download.
Yeah. Okay. So if you show the thing, and then it's interesting because you're like, what is this? I don't understand. I don't get it. You know.
All right. I found it. Hold on a second. See, I'm getting pretty good at this thing on the fly, huh?
Yeah, you do.
All right. Here we go. Let's go to the screen.
So show the thing first. All right. Cool.
Here we go.
Well, I mean, you got to show the. All right. Whatever. That's fine. So this is kind of the story behind the
oh my God.
The render, right? The story behind the render. So
nice.
And you'll get it. It makes a lot more sense.
Illuminati confirmed.
I don't. So he's just moving around in Octane?
Just wait.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
He's got energizer batteries back
there.
Wait,
what is that?
Hot pockets.
That's why he had the hot pocket screen on the.
It's been hot pockets
behind
all along.
Him.
Yeah, dude.
It's been hot pockets all along. Man, dang, dude.
I'm curious if this is some sort of viral marketing for hot pockets. Like hot pockets was
Maybe.
Like, we need more people who eat hot pockets to be eating hot pockets. Who can we get? let's get people.
But this is it's
what
it's
are millennials
like, so
like?
Disgusting.
What are millennials
like,
like?
I feel like it would, if anything, it would turn people off of Hot Pockets. But I don't know, people are sick like that, so you never know.
Yeah, dude,
millennials
it's
like the Toy Story, right? Yeah, and they like Kim Jong Un and Hillary Clinton. Well, let's
like,
just Google those
like
three
nostalgia.
Terms and see what comes up. Oh, this guy Beeple, he likes all three of those things. Let's get him to do a Hot Pockets promotion.
Yeah,
that's how it's like, advertising works, right?
On the Beyond Meat, someone thought that he was like just, you know, promoting Beyond Meat and doing all of these environmentally conscious things, but it's also like extremely fucked up concept. It's like I don't know if this is like promoting Beyond Meat or showing like the horrible future that we're all destined towards. Yeah.
Mm. Yeah.
All right. I'm gonna go back to the Beeple viewer of choice here and let's just go through these real quick because these are great.
Of course. That one was done live.
Which one's this one?
That one was done live. So I'm assuming at some point, yeah, that one was done live at some meetup or something like that.
Because the name of it,
Instagram.
The name of it is like Heinel.
Yeah.
He just.
So I'm assuming. I'm assuming they had. You know, someone said you've got to start with the Buzz Lightyear head. You know. This one's really pretty. He did a behind the scenes on Instagram of like how he was building that one. You know,
time lapse for that one. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then, this is great.
This one's a reference to our Panini video.
Yes.
Is it really?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. And then did you see Lil Nas actually commented on this?
Oh, I
did. Oh, did he really?
Yeah.
What did he say?
Just scroll down. He said, fuck, you're good.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I don't
know. And so did Mike Diva. Mike Diva is the director who Ryan and I worked with.
Where can I see all the replies?
You got to click on it, I think.
Oh, go to Instagram. Oh, Instagram.
Oh, he said it on Instagram?
Yeah.
Oh, I can't find it on Instagram.
But Lil Nas retweeted it on Twitter, so it definitely, that one blew up a lot.
Yeah, no one. Oh, wait. Oh, Lil Not X.
Oh, jeez.
Anyway. All right. What else? Yeah, that's awesome. Cause that's the first thing I thought because I saw your video. And as soon as I saw this, I was like, oh my God.
Yeah. I feel like he's really smart. I think he's like intentionally trying to attract certain artists, you know?
Wait a minute.
Like Hot Pockets. Well, yeah. Are you sure these aren't Hot Pockets? Did you see his thing the other day? those might be Hot Pockets. Paninis, no, those are
maybe
Paninis.
They're Hot Pockets. They're Paninis.
Did you see the thing that he posted when he was trying to get Hot Pockets' attention, where it was like he was reading some article on online where it's saying, if you want to get the attention of like a big brand or something like that, do like artwork or something focused towards them and try and get them mm-hmm. to retweet the story, you know? And so that's mm-hmm. when he created this one, the Hot Pockets mm-hmm. one. It's so much more interesting, like, people story when you actually follow him on Instagram and like get the stories right. and stuff,
the
you know,
the scenes.
So he did this one and he was trying to get Hot Pockets' attention, you know, by saying, hey, Hot Pockets, you know, and sending them actual like messages and stuff like that saying, I don't know. It was really funny. And then he had to backtrack and he's like, please don't sue me, Hot Pockets.
That's really funny. Zed commented on this one. He said, looks like my new production. Which is really funny because I was like, what's he talking about? Oh, yeah. And then, you know, I'm working on this Zed stuff with Beeple. And these rocks in the background are the exact rocks we used in one of the songs called Beautiful Now.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah,
I love Beautiful Now. I'm trying
Beautiful
to find.
Now.
And then the build-up.
The title of this. I love it.
It's always the everyone, build-up. Though. Yeah.
Everyone. Yeah. The title of this, Organic Virgin Baby Hearts New,
right.
at Hot Pockets Flavor. Yeah.
No, this is the thing right here. Let me pull this up. See, he's got
yeah,
it in
yeah,
the
yeah.
background
yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah.
of
yeah.
the video that yeah. he did, too. Yeah. There's some Illuminati
maybe,
Hot Pockets
maybe
stuff
he's
going
being,
on.
Maybe he's being controlled by Hot Pockets. I'm telling you. I'm
Is
telling
it
you,
another
I bet
message?
You anything. No, I bet you anything. It's like he's getting paid by Hot Pockets. I bet you anything. Hmm. He's getting. It's
underground
like
underground viral marketing.
Underground viral marketing for Hot Pockets.
Hot Pockets. Okay.
I mean, like
Check
you,
this one
you
out.
Saw all the stuff that KFC was doing, right? You know.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah,
yeah,
yeah.
Might be. I mean, this
I
could
do
be
love
a,
this one.
This could be it too. No, he said nothing gross or weird or inappropriate. Just a cute baby piglet enjoying his day.
Yeah.
And then the next day.
The next day, he's in a Hot Pocket.
Is he?
Right?
No.
The pig will be in a Hot Pocket tomorrow. He'll be
no, the next next day.
No, next,
next day,
day,
he's got a pig with a head cut off.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, you don't know. That could be a different pig. This pig is in the Hot Pocket.
Well, right. yeah, currently.
He got slaughtered.
See, that's
can we,
the next
can
day.
Can we go to...
Yeah, there you yeah. go. To this
I
one?
I love that.
Yeah, yeah, there's no head. This one is called... What's it called? Pig Moon Rising?
Pig Moon Rising.
Yeah,
I see
a big pig.
A pig moon,
I knew that.
Rising.
Moon rising.
And here's the one that has the Hot Pockets thing on the back. Kim Jong-un rebrand.
So
I mean, that's
on this
crazy
one,
he's combining
got, like,
everything.
Easter eggs in there that like you can't even see because it's behind
yeah.
the Kim Jong.
Yeah. In the story awesome. In the story on Instagram, basically it was the two little green soldiers were talking to each other, and he goes, wow, he appeals to everyone. I know, he's got like everything that people enjoy, like big old titties, Buzz Lightyear, Pikachu, you know? What wouldn't you like?
And it was really Nazis, funny. Like, you know,
and
of course.
Nazis. Yeah.
And Nazis.
And it's American flags, if you
confetti,
notice.
Every, these are all yep. the best things in the world.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. All right, then we got this one. This is the Beyond Meat one.
Oh. I love the lighting in this.
Yeah.
And just the overall atmosphere is great.
Yeah.
But yeah, like this guy, if you scroll down on Instagram, there's this guy that's like overly analyzing it or just saying, you know, how inspiring it is. Your art is already incredibly inspiring, but from my perspective, this piece and the Pig Moon Rising have established you as an extraordinarily influential or as extraordinarily influential in the history of modern art. Please continue to address the collective ignorance and trip out the masses with imagery relating mass factory farming and animal suffering to the societal dissonance resultant from post-industrialization. This is progressive and conscious raising work you're doing. Thank you.
Yeah, and that's the intent, is to fight the power.
Fight the power.
Yeah.
I don't know. Yeah. It's, and then, people just get... Yeah.
This was... Oh, then this is yesterday. Fever Dream.
Yeah, this one was pretty good.
I wonder if he's sick. Are you sick, people? Maybe that's why he didn't answer you back. He had a fever dream yesterday.
Too busy watching Fox News. And CNN at the same time.
And CNN at the same time. Yeah. They balance each other out.
Yep.
Right.
Okay, are y'all ready to get out of here? Because I got a lot of editing to do now.
Yeah, I guess so. Why not? Sure, yeah. Let's do it.
Cool. All right. Thanks, everybody, for hanging around and checking out our episode 200. We'll be back to a normal show, kind of.
In a couple
next
weeks.
Week. No, it's the one we're recording thanks. Tomorrow. And
thanks for having me on, you guys.
Yeah, dude, man. Thanks for being on. And
congrats for episode 200. Yeah.
It's been
no, thank you
long,
for episode 200.
No, thank you.
No, thank you.
No, thank you.
Anyway, you can rate us on iTunes, leave a review. You can subscribe on your podcatcher of choice. It helps get our ratings up. Subscribe to our newsletter that goes out monthly now, the Mograph.com newsletter. You can say you've been there, done that, got the t-shirt with the Mograph logo tee, the Paul Bab Feel the Bab 2020 shirt. All the profits from that goes to Doctors Without Borders, the Render Things shirt, hoodie, and long sleeve tee, and then the That Render Is Fire shirt. It's just a t-shirt. And we're on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Periscope, YouTube, Mograph.com. Make sure that you subscribe to our new channels because the other ones are going away. It's episode 200.
Speaking of subscribers,
I feel like we should
channel.
Be turning that off.
I just got an email saying, I'm a shit at Blender has subscribed to you on YouTube. All right, cool.
I think that, yeah, it's funny because we still have people subscribing to the old channel. I'm like, stop it. Stop subscribing to the old channel.
I wonder
channel.
If you can, like, can't stop people from subscribing.
I don't think you can stop people from subscribing, but you can stop posting stuff, which is what I'm going to do.
Yeah.
So. Mm-hmm. We're going to get out of here. I'm going to finish the rest of this scotch.
Cool.
And I'm going to edit the show.
Try and do some work.
All right.
Yeah.
Cool, man.
So until next week, I'm Dave.
And I'm Matt.
I'm David.
And I'm
have a
EJ.
Good one.
Later, you.
I'm EJ, guys. Hey, good. I got to go.
I'm EJ.
Yeah.
Man.
Man. Yeah.
Later, yo.
Man. Buddy.
On to episode 400!
It's pretty good, I guess.
Mograph.com, an online resource for motion graphic artists. Start your week with the Mograph podcast. Industry news, interviews with your favorite artists, and terrible humor. Watch live shows and interviews from Mograph events like NAB, Seagraph, Half-Res, and local meetups. Our Mograph talks feature live demos and motivation from artists all around the world.
Sometimes you gotta make stuff that you're not gonna put on your reel, and I'm not here to judge.
What if Rick and Morty show up for the countdown at midnight? That's where I peaked in life, in my career.
We gotta stop this thing, Rick! It's gonna kill us all!
Hear from the people that create your software, design your render engines, and artists that are changing the face of modern motion graphics.
You get that render done. Yeah, you better frame what?
Mograph tutorials and online classes will teach you about Cinema 4D, After Effects, as well as other popular software and render engines.
Throw in HDR Studio, take the render settings, pick the HDR, put in a reflection, and gorgeous!
Branch into new software, learn time-saving tips, techniques, workflows, and lessons that'll keep you up to date in the world of motion design.
Oh, brother, those are some of my favorite elves.
I love projects that scare me. When our art director comes to us and asks for something that I had never done before, man, it gets me pumped.
Join the conversation in our live sessions, check out our plugins, or join the hundreds of daily active users in our Slack channel for technical help, advice, contests, or just to joke around.
Real nice banana.
Yeah, that's so funny. All right. I'm going to live forever.
Subscribe today and get the latest updates on our YouTube and other social media channels.
Take all your dreams and just do it.
We don't care how you get here, folks. Just get here.
Subscribe to Mograph.com.